listening to a podcast of the Geek I.O. Media Network. For all of our shows and more, visit geek-io.net. And to help support the network, head over to patreon.com/geek-io.
Hello, gentle listener. While Geek I.O. holds its talent to the highest standard, what follows will likely involve the sort of language usually reserved for sailors on leave. If you're of a delicate disposition, then perhaps you would consider a different podcast.
Call it our grief. Geeking out across the globe, hold on to your butts, it's the Geek I.O. Show!
The Geek I.O. Show! Hooray, don't you
Yes, indeed! Hello, friends, and welcome! My voice is back so I can yell! This is the Geek I.O. Show, episode number 230, your podcaster playground, recorded Thursday. Holy shit, it's February, the 1st of February 2018. I am CJ, two children fused into one older man boat.
I'm Dale, gotta make them leaves move with my steel rake Campbell.
I'm Carrie, totally not going to yell into the camera because, ow, Wilcox.
Ow.
I'm Josh. I'm actually not all that tired for once.
Holy crap.
What?
And joining us this week, costing four but needing two red, the double striker who can attack your battle cards, know where the fuck they stand, and gains over 9,000 power when doing it, the Fist of Justice, Peter Catani!
Hey guys, yay! What's going on?
Hey!
Clap for myself.
Oh, you can clap yourself. You can do that. That's fine.
Last time I clapped myself too much, I went blind. So don't do it too much.
No.
That was yesterday.
But how's everyone doing? Thank you for having me.
Dude, thank you for coming on. Appreciate it. Appreciate it.
No, of course.
Oh, yeah, appreciate
it. I played that so much while we're talking. I'm shuffling this deck just to see how this deck plays.
No, that's fair. Like, there have been times, like, we can throughout the game, Peter, like, throughout the show, we can, like, try and do a demo game. That'll make a great show.
Make a great show.
I have my mono blue Vegeta right here. Like I said last time, Peter is the most recent regional Dragon Ball
Super. Most regional.
Winning Richmond, Virginia by taking his teammate, slamming him into the ground several times, and then glaring at him funny.
Yes. Even though he was supposed to win, that was, yeah. I robbed my teammate from double championship because he won Vegas and then he was undefeated the whole day. From day one and day two till he got to the finals. And I robbed that one, that streak from him. But it was a great game. Great time.
Ooh, it was so close. You almost had it.
Yep.
I would have paid to have seen that one. I was actually planning on making it out to Richmond, mainly as a kind of a correspondent kind of thing because, man, like, I'm not great at this game. Like, I can win some locals, but Jesus, man, like, getting on the stage and doing anything like that. I wanted to get out there and do some stuff for here, and just couldn't make it. I would have killed to see that match, man.
I wish it was recorded. It's probably the best game I've ever played.
Yeah, that's another reason why I wanted to make it out there, try and, you know, talk to ARG and do some...
There's some sticky fingers in the chat. Don't let them near your cards.
They want to ask CJ a question.
You want to ask me a question? Sure, yes. Absolutely. Hey, by the way, Twitch chat is real live tonight, so this is going to be a real weird show, y'all.
Yeah, we're live.
Yes, what in sticky fingers wants to ask me a question? Go ahead and ask your questions and we'll answer them when we see him on the Twitch chat. Why do I look like a fucking weirdo? Because I do.
It's called genetics. Sometimes they suck.
Yep.
Right.
Well, bye, wooden sticky fingers. Appreciate it.
It's called put a pillow up your shirt. And there's a callback for free.
I'm so sorry you ran into that side of the internet.
You're right. All right. So let us get on moving into the first segment of the show. Gadgets, Games, Gizmos.
Gadgets, Games, and Gizmos. Pew, 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 pew.
Gadgets, Games, and Gizmos. We're talking about the stuff that we have been playing on for last week or so. I probably know the answer to this one, but Peter, what have you been up to for the last week?
Working. It really wasn't even playtesting, it was working. My job was remodel, and they opened last week, or we're trying to get everything together. I work in a mall in Miami, and retail, it sucks. It's horrible. It's horrible. Yes, yes. Especially when my store is a bunch of girls, so they use the big guy to grab all the boxes, and there's a lot of boxes.
Of course they do.
The first day was 13 hours, the next day after was 15, and the last day was 12, and then I finally got to leave because I'm like, all right, screw it, I'm going indie. And yeah, but I am real painful. I haven't got any playtesting. We tried to do it today, and even then, today, we're still all lost. We don't know what the hell we're playing for indie, but we still got a day, so that's good, right?
Yeah, that's how that works. That works always works out well.
Exactly how that works. That's retail in a nutshell, right?
I have 24 hours. I could do this. Stay up until 3 a.m. when you have to wake up at 5 tomorrow. Fuck.
No, it's like 5 a.m. 5 a.m. is usually like in every event, the Orlando, the Vegas. I'm up till 5 a.m. playtesting, trying to make the deck perfect. Because the big events, I don't need sleep. I'm okay. Afterwards, my body's just destroyed.
Crash.
Yeah, it's super crashed, but at least I'm focused in the whole event, so that's positive thinking.
Well, that's good, considering the whole event is, what, 9 hours? No breaks?
Ten, because it's 9 rounds, but, like, since some go into time, and some actually like to stall out on those, you round it off to 10.
Yeah.
Legit. It's over 9 hours!
What? 9 hours? That's impossible!
That's pretty good. Yeah, I did one of the Pan Z regionals, the Orlando Pan Z regional last year, and like I got 32 in it, and just like by the time I was done, I just considered not doing anything else. Like even the next day, I didn't know if I could freaking deal with that anymore. Like,
yeah, no, understandable. That's exactly what Saturdays feel like. It's 9 rounds, and I'm good for like 4. Maybe 5, because like our locals are like that. It's like 4 to 5 rounds in our locals. And cool, you know, I'm having a good time. 9? Nah. By round 4, I'm like, dude, no way. I don't want to lose, but like, I don't care at that point. I'm like, let's go. It's not until you get to like round 7, out of 9 rounds, once you get to round 7, depending on your record, all you need to do is be a good record where you can technically draw. You're not trying to draw. Hell, you can lose for all you care. If you're undefeated by round 7, the next 2 rounds, hey, man, good job. You win. I don't care for records. I don't care for standings. I don't care for any of that stuff. As long as I make day 2, that's the goal. Day 2 is when you really play.
Yep.
Day 1 is just when you have the mindset to play it.
Legit.
No, it drains.
Yeah. Like I love playing competitively like that, but just, man, after, yeah, like you get that last little burst when you realize, oh shit, I only have 2 matches to play. I can make it through this, but the rest, like, between like round four and round eight, like what is happening? I don't understand. But thankfully, like, well, most of the time you play test enough that your deck just kind of runs itself.
Yeah. Most of the time. That's not the case right now.
Yeah.
and the most important thing is you got to play a deck that you like. And me, I don't like playing meta too much. Like in Orlando, since Mecha Frieza was kind of new, we all knew it was good, but it was kind of new, so it was still fun to play it.
Because everything's in Vegas.
Yeah, no, but in Vegas, I had like a boring time because like I was so dumb with Mecha, and I just hated how like every time you draw your hand, like, you're praying to God a little bit. You're like, please give me Monaco, please. No, oh, God damn it. And then it becomes a slow game. Horrible. When I went to Richmond with a Goku deck, I had fun playing that deck. Thank you. Problem is, everyone was playing it. The mirror match were AIDS, so I'm not playing it again. Even though I love the leader, I can't play it again. Mentally, I'm just like, I can't play this. I want to play Bobby, but no one in my team will let me. And that's understandable because I know I can't do this big event. But I love how Bobby plays. I like the whole ball, the big Majin Buu, all that shit. That's me. And I'm sorry. I'm sorry. PG-13.
No, dude. In the email was, if you wanted it to be PG-13, I played the disclaimer at the beginning of the show. We don't give a fuck.
All right, perfect. Just to make sure.
Yeah, it's up to you if you want us to keep it PG-13. You don't tell us to keep it PG-13, we're off the rails.
She'll take me out of the rails to begin with.
Right.
Perfect, yeah, I like this.
We understand the concept of rails, but they're more like guidelines.
We just had a random commenter in the chat asking,
why it looks so fucking weird. But I mean, bravo for just flat out asking that. Appreciate it. Like, you know,
let's be honest, we don't know what fucking rails are. We don't live our life on rails.
There's something about
them, in fact.
They're light rails. We can have heavy rails, but not light.
So, Peter, you get to choose who gets to go next. It's the little game that we play.
Okay. So 2 seconds. Let me go to that screen where I see everyone. All right. So, we're going to play Raul because he has his mic turned off. Oh, he's not on the show. I'm so lying. Oh my God. I'm embarrassed. Okay. So Dale, you're next because you answered that question. Congratulations.
Thank you. Congratulations. You answered the question.
Yeah. Dale's usually the one asking the questions.
Get the prize.
Yeah, normally I'm the one asking the questions, not answering them. This is weird. I haven't been up to much, apart from working and being a yawn, because the month of February, they've decided to, again, I work in retail, and they've decided to, at the beginning of February, make sure all the floors are polished, and then, because they do that every quarter. And of course, we're not a big supermarket, but we're big enough to where we have to basically reschedule everyone, like the day of, and go, we need to get like these 6 areas done before 9 p.m. because that's when the polishing starts. And then you've got people who are legitimately allergic to the polishing stuff. So you can't roster them on because, you know, they've got a known condition. And if you get them very sick, people can be bedridden for up to like 3 days off the toxic smells of them.
Floor polish is a terrible, terrible scent.
The thing that gets me is the floor stripper and the primer that they use before the polish.
Stripper is the best stripper though. Like, because then you get the pole stripper, but they expect you to pay them.
Right, and then, well, the floor stripper, they can just, like, Magikarp spread out all over the floor and do, like, Magikarp. I was meant to say Starfish.
What is a Magikarp spread?
A Magikarp spread.
Peter, well, do you know what a Magikarp spread is?
Do you know what a Magikarp spread is?
It looks kind of weird, and there's a whole lot of splashing going around, but nothing really happens.
All right, I'm going to go to Urban Dictionary. It's been a hot minute since we've done this.
Oh, no.
Yes, Dale reads Urban Dictionary.
Magic.
It exists, of course, which it probably doesn't, to be honest. That's probably something.
What is it? Spread. I was going to say splash. It is. But apart from Magikarp spreading all over the place, there are no definitions for Magikarp spread.
Aw.
Wow. I'm surprised at you, Internet.
Right? Internet, I'm proud of you. I'm proud of you. You grow up so fast. But apart from that, I finally finished Please Like Me, the TV series that I was working my way through. And the final series, it got canned, it turned out. I was doing a bit of research. It got canned after 6 episodes. So the 6th episode was literally just rushing to finish as many plot lines as possible.
Jeez. Oof.
3 people died, people got married, there was like a couple of people that got dumped, all in this half an hour window.
Jesus. It's like an episode of Jerry Springer.
Yeah, right? But the shortened edition. Wait, were they half an hour, or are they an hour? been a hot minute since I've seen Jerry Springer.
You know, Madison, actually.
I like that.
I know. You like that? A hot minute. I say it all the time. I know I shouldn't, but I do.
No, no, that sounds pretty cool. I'm going to start using that. That's a hot minute.
I haven't done this in a hot minute. Please don't start using Magikarp spreading, though.
I'm going to mess around with my girl. After like we mess around, I'll be like, that was a hot minute.
Only a minute?
Only a minute. Hey. That's what the joke's for.
But apparently, I'm still waiting for the newest George Clooney episode. George Clooney episode of the new David Letterman series. Apparently, it's coming out next week. So they're not weekly episodes, apparently.
Huh? It's on Netflix, right?
It is on Netflix.
So it's whenever the fuck they feel like it.
Right.
Whenever.
Why
whenever
did we drop this at 4 a.m. just for shit?
Right now. And then, yeah, because David Letterman's very busy these days. He has to attend all those Gandalf conventions.
He has to escort a bunch of hobbits places.
Yeah, and then, yeah, saying that they can't pass, like, at all. And then the rest of his time is spreading.
Worst teacher, you shall not pass. But you haven't even started the class yet.
Could you imagine if...
I had a teacher who did that.
Oh, really?
Yes.
It's okay. Everyone passes the second time around.
Right? There you go. Everyone passes the second time around.
Yeah, it's a little
pass to the left.
That's the definition of this show. But anyway, so, yeah, I'm still waiting for that. So, you know, and apart from that, I haven't been really that boring. I have been that boring. And excited to have the one podcast I do back on the air.
Yeah.
So, I'm going to hand it off now to Kerry. What have you been up to?
Aside from work, I decided that before I get into playing things like Horizon Zero Dawn that I really want to get into, I should finish up Tales of Zestiria, which I'm almost finished with. So I got back into that after like a year. And when you pick up a Tales game after a year of not playing it,
yeah,
real fun to try and figure out. Like, I'm pretty sure I spent like an hour just reading through the in-game journals and stuff to remember how to do shit.
Yeah. It's the reason why I've never picked back up Berseria, because it's just been forever since I played it.
Yeah. I got some new yarn, because I'm going to be knitting eventually a shawl designed by our friend Quarrelsome Rhino.
Yeah.
So I got some new yarn. It's very pretty.
Exciting.
Carrie's yarn pouring hour.
And so the members of the Robot House went to Distant Worlds over the weekend.
What?
We were literally in the front row and got to hear some beautiful, beautiful music and see the absolute joy on Nobuo Uematsu's face as people went wild cheering for him. He's that the happiest composer you've ever seen in your entire life. Fun story, though. As they were playing the prelude, the power went out to the theater. The entire thing, the entire room was plunged into pitch blackness. I mean, like, pitch blackness. Like, the touch tunnel at Great Exploration's dark here. Jesus.
People outside of Tampa Bay know what that is.
I'm sure other museums have touch tunnels. Basically,
lots of places have touch tunnels, if you know what I mean.
People Magikarp spread in touch tunnels.
Okay, moving on.
found Carrie's hard stop.
I'm trying to tell a cool thing.
All right, sorry.
No, but the orchestra just kept playing like nothing had happened at all. The only reason we knew that it wasn't fake wasn't staged was because the lights came back on. Number one, it was the emergency lighting, and number two, the whole poor concert master was looking around like, what the fuck just happened? And then, right as everything rebooted and the stage lights came back on, they finished the prelude with the victory theme.
That's fantastic. I really wanted to go with you guys.
And, yeah. Next time they come around, because they have been touring now for 10 years, I doubt they're going to stop anytime soon.
Right.
Yeah, I mean, it's been 30 years of Final Fantasy games, and we're only at, what, 15?
That's not that much.
No.
Nah.
Well, like, every other year, not including all the really bad sequels.
Not including all the other bad sequels. Nice.
So yeah, Distant Worlds and Yarn and trying and mostly succeeding to play Tales of Zestiria. I actually managed to beat a couple of bosses just by button mashing. And on to Josh.
But Josh is boring.
Yay!
Josh.
Cool. Pretty boring.
So, the Sunday we went to see Distant Worlds was my only day off that week. I worked 6 days straight. I'm in the middle of the next 6 days straight, and I get Sunday off again. There is a distinct chance I may be a little bit tired on Saturday, Manipoolers. But I will power through because I love you all and I want to kill you. I mean...
Not kill me yet! I just joined! Wait, never mind.
But that's the best time! You watched the light die from your eyes because you were so excited to start a new adventure. I mean... Yeah. Bit of a sad note. Our beloved chiropractor is no longer with the practice.
Aww.
So, she was supposed to be moving on to a better job opportunity in Georgia. We were told that may no longer be the case by a colleague of hers, but she was not there, nor were her degrees and certificates when I got there today to have my back cracked like I direly needed. So, God only knows if we'll ever figure out the end of that mystery. So we'll see what happens. I'm hoping she got the fantastic job opportunity, which she was very, very happy about, because she is a wonderful woman and deserves every good thing that comes her way. So, yeah.
Yeah, but if everything went missing and gone...
Well, no, not missing, so. But there were... You know how when something is hanging on a wall for a real long time and then you move it and you can tell exactly where it was hanging? That was where her diplomas for the colleges of chiropractic and stuff were when I went to see her today and she wasn't there.
Aww.
So... I'm really hoping that she actually got to go to her fantastic new job opportunity, and we were just slightly misinformed by someone else. Yeah. But it was sad to go in expecting to see her today and having her not be there. So. But I digress. Have not had much time at all for gaming, other than the occasional nightly bout of bashing my head against the wall that is League of Legends.
I still don't get it, bro.
What?
I don't understand why you hate yourself so much.
I mean, I could send you like
other games that are free to play and much better.
I could send you.
I don't know.
That's what you're desperate for. Like,
I don't know what it is either. To be perfectly honest, it's one of the few games that I've actually played for as long as I have without giving up on it. But yeah, the new ranked season has started for the year, and everybody's scrambling to place and bloody bloody frickin' blah. And I ran into one of the shining examples of the League community, known as the Riven main. Riven is one of the female champions in the game. She's an edgy white-haired emo girl from a militaristic empire who is one of the stupidest fucking champions in the game. Even from a design standpoint, I'm sorry. Having a low cooldown shield that is based on how much damage you've built? That's not design cohesion, guys. It don't make sense.
Someone messed up.
right? But unfortunately, this particular champion attracts certain types of people that love to think that they shit gold because they're good at this objectively terribly designed champion.
I mean, we in Dragon Ball Super call those Mecha Frieza players.
Nice. Nice.
But the moral of the story is, it feels real damn good when the Riven main spends all game flashing their mastery at you after killing you repeatedly, and then they still lose the game.
Yeah, Mecha Frieza players.
Right. Yeah, that's
he
great.
He wasn't wrong. Yeah,
you can use your busted ass combos on me all you want. Guess what? Your base just exploded. We won. Where is your mastery flash now?
Yeah.
But yeah, other than that, looking forward to Saturday when I get to torture some of these people with my Metapool game. Which is our live play, role play podcast for those who are familiar or not familiar with the network. They're letting me have fun with a huge sandbox right now, and I'm kind of tormenting with them. I promise there's no 13-hour boss fight this time, guys.
Just remember, I carry around a pouch of not fireworks on me at all times. Just
I know.
Okay, just so you know.
I know.
In case you forgot.
It's okay, Team Mom has magical sleeves. Also, hi, Moru's grandma.
Hello, Moru Ma.
We have our first grandma? That's fantastic.
Right?
My first grandma.
Go for the grandma.
We're getting all the
right.
Nice.
Outside of that, not a whole lot going on at the moment. Still fiddling around with my assorted army of robots. Probably going to build something again here sometime soon. I'm not sure yet. Still trying to get the cave back under control after Christmas. Looking at you, Christmas tree.
Just take it. It'll take itself down. Although, yeah, again, like...
Well, no, it's artificial. Eventually, it's just going to gain sentience and transform into something, which I am...
Which I'm going to say, which fits right in with your house. Like, what are you complaining about?
Exactly.
The fact that it's taking time. I'm like, come on. Branch out already.
Raul wants to know if you found the dropped robot part.
You know, I have not, Raul. I've been looking for it. That little fist is still MIA.
Nice.
Probably have to give the carpet a good once over before we actually vacuum up the fallen fake Christmas tree needles.
Yeah. Right.
Yeah. But yeah, I mean, ours is still up like too. We finally made progress on ours and at least, you know, removed the decorations from it. That's
yeah, ours is dark as well, unfortunately.
Yeah, it's like you see just the a fake Christmas tree without the lights is just sad.
Any Christmas tree that isn't decorated is kind of sad.
See, ours still has the lights on it, CJ. We just don't have any ornaments on it. I can throw the straw on top.
Ours plugs in. That's right.
Again, you can just throw some love hearts and some cupids on it and just call it a Valentine's Day tree.
I'm going to. And then I'm going to throw fucking shamrocks and shit on it. Little fucking leprechauns. Lots of gold. After that, we'll throw, let's see, we'll be in May, so we'll throw some extra fucking eggs.
Oh, I filed my taxes the other night. Actually getting money back, so get some stuff done with that,
huge.
And eventually maybe get myself some new robots, because I don't have enough.
Maybe also pay off the person for Dragon Con.
I'm sorry, what? I couldn't hear you.
Oh, yeah, me either.
What?
Gets my throat, just, I get so, you know, man.
Verklempt. I'm very verklempt. I love that word.
Now, why would you use a Jewish word? Are you trying to say Jews are money grabbers?
No.
Now, darling, don't go there.
Wouldn't be wrong
either. All right, who's next?
Well, it would have to be either CJ or Rachel, so... lady not appearing in this podcast.
You mean the disembodied voice?
Invisible wife 2.0.
You sound different.
Invisible wife, disembodied voice.
Disembodied wife? What?
Disembodied wife! All that, better disembodied than disemboweled. I mean, shit.
Time out. I'm canceling this.
I mean, it's my wife. If I want to call her disemboweled, I can.
Next time on Doki Doki Literature Club.
Oh, Jesus.
Hey, you walked into that one. What have I been doing? Oh, I'm slacking off on my college courses because that's what I feel like doing.
Yeah, she should be working, but she's talking to us assholes.
No. I'm technically working. I'm monitoring chat. I'm kind of writing an IEP with, you know, none of it in front of me. So why not? This is what happens when you get miffed at your job and just don't want to do anything because you've had a craptastic day and would rather come on the podcast and, you know, bitch about it.
Geek.io, we're better than shitty days.
Craptastic day. That's awesome.
Better than a craptastic day. There you go.
Well, the little
I'm learning all those cool words.
Yeah, Geek.io.
When you scrub out tomorrow, because you know that's something that'll happen.
Oh, man.
Yeah, of course.
I might.
Yeah, playtesting?
Yeah, who needs playtesting?
Yeah.
Just get up and go, it was a hot minute, and then just walk away.
A hot minute, yeah, exactly.
So, I actually have been playing games. Of course, they're not, you know, run-of-the-mill games, because I don't have a life and I don't do anything. I downloaded two stupid games onto my cell phone, because why not? One that's called Snake vs. Block, which is snake ramming into blocks. When you ram into blocks, piece of snake explodes.
When you run into them, do you hear wing?
I'm sure there's sounds in it, but I never have the sound up because I do this at work. And then there's one called Drop the Ball, and actually I've got a third one.
Thank you, Josh. Thank you. I'm glad somebody got my stupid joke.
I'm just ignoring your stupid joke. I live with you. It is a stupid joke.
Oh, bad wife.
Nani?
Oh my god. So
here I am throwing a ball around and it blinks off the walls and it bounces off of other balls and then I miss it and it tells me, oh, you suck, try again. And it's stupid fun. Like, I never thought watching a ball bounce off of stationary things would be fun, but it kind of is. There may or may not be a window there, CJ.
I think we all were going there.
Oh, absolutely.
Breaking news. No one goes to Target because they need something. You go to Target and let Target tell you what you need.
Yes.
Exactly.
100%.
Oh, that's why you go to Amazon too, right?
Pretty much.
No, I go to Amazon to shop for air conditioner filters in my pajamas. Because that's an adult
thing. I would too if I had an air conditioner.
You still don't have an AC.
It's still a weird thing when we're just as hot as you in summer, Dale, here, some days.
Dale, you mean the maintenance crew, which is lax at best in my place here, is actually better than your maintenance guy?
Hey, Rachel, don't dox us.
I mean, don't, yeah. Considering I've got their main form of transport in my room, it makes it a little...
Dale, if you want that AC fixed, you should probably let their kangaroo go.
No, I'm never letting the kangaroo go.
Yeah, I mean, then what is he going to jerk?
Hashtag free to kangaroo. Hashtag kangaroo lives matter.
Kangaroo lives matter.
Kangaroo lives matter.
All right.
This lives matter.
Good boy. All
right. Now, see, I go to Amazon to shop for random things to put in vegan recipes that apparently I'm actually pretty decent at. So, CJ, you can take over from here. I'm going to go back to being a disembodied voice again.
All right.
No. Oh, I'm going to miss her.
Still,
yeah.
As is the usual, because I apparently have more of a life than the rest of you losers.
that just happened.
obligatory, aside from work, and I'm not happy about work right now, but so I've been playing Warframe a lot lately. That's fun. Delbert of the Gamer Geeks podcast has been helping me out a lot with that one. Yeah, it's fun. I also have been playing Dragon Ball FighterZ, and we were going to play Dragon Ball FighterZ on Wednesday, but Bandai decides it's a good idea at 8 p.m. on a Wednesday to have fucking maintenance. Not that I'm salty.
You seem a little salty.
We're all out of margarita mix, CJ. Stop it.
I know. So, played Puyo Tetris instead. I did play a couple rounds. Well, it wasn't just Rachel beating you, by the way. You are just that bad at Puyo Tetris.
You did beat CJ once.
Yeah, you beat me once, but I still beat you, like, we played, what, 8 games? I won twice out of all those, and you beat me once, which is the only time that you won. It's because I also started chugging at that point.
Which... yeah, there are clips that I clipped out of.
Also, DJ. I have been putting out quite a bit of voice acting tryouts lately because that's something.
That's awesome.
Hoping to hear something back on one of them. Actually, I've heard back on one of them, but I'm not allowed to say which one yet. Carrie and Josh know what one. I've told them before.
Are you allowed to say if it was good hear back?
Yeah, it is good hear back.
Yay.
I have a role, and I'm not allowed to say what it is yet.
Because if it was a bad hearback, I don't think he cares if he wasn't allowed to say it.
Yeah,
or not.
Exactly. I got denied the role of Princess Sparkle in Epic Team Pop's dub.
No, Princess Sparkle.
It's really Princess Sparkle's alter ego. She's fabulous.
Also, Epic Team Pop is real fucking weird if you watch anime. Like, it's so weird. the dub is even weirder because it has Chris Sabat as one of the lead characters in it. It's so weird hearing Vegeta in that one. And he's straight up Vegeta in it. But yeah, I've been doing that. I've also been playing around Dragon Ball Super cards because that's what I do. I sit in last during the last show. I built this mono blue Vegeta deck, and I don't know how it plays. I have waifu sleeves on it though, so there's that. The waifu. I don't know who she is.
Damn, those are waifu as fuck.
And then Vegeta, because of course Vegeta.
Of course.
Vegeta, yes.
Because even before Vegeta turned out Vegeta was good, I've pretty much played Vegeta main because Vegeta's my dude. Other than that, like, I haven't been doing much either. I'm mostly playing Warframe and FighterZ.
Okay.
FighterZ is real good.
If you're good at fighting games, yeah, it's really good. Them,
well, I mean, that's the conundrum, isn't it?
I mean, it's an Arxis game, so it rewards just smashing the hell out of buttons.
Ooh.
Moving Peter.
Well, I mean, you got him excited.
All right. So, on that note, we are going to take a quick break.
And there goes the video.
Yeah, the streams of. Yeah. Raul's on it.
Yeah. So, while Raul's fixing breaking things, I am going to, we're going to go take a quick break. And on the other end of the show, or on the other end of that, we will be talking to Peter more so about, being a professional player, what it takes to be good at games and that kind of thing. So, for our podcast listeners, you will also hear a quick word from our sponsors. Support them, support us, support everything. We'll see you. The song that we're going to play... forgot to do. I played her a couple weeks ago. This lovely woman by the name of Melinda Kathleen Reese. She does songs that she runs through Google Translate. And this week's song is the titular song from the play Hamilton. So, we'll be right back. Stay tuned.
What makes a best orphanage punk? This is Carey Curry and his game. Results will be published in Providence, Indonesia. Who is the prime minister and the university? Father, 10 yen, you have a lot of jobs and need to put forth effort. Alcoholics are very wise. Personal planning after 8 years. He made a great car. He killed all the servers on the day he died. He may be tempted to protect and serve. Internet connection is required, brother. Any rent stolen or white. It's a lot of baldness and bribery. Our husband saw in the upcoming autumn and drowned in the toilet. Put the spoon in a sacred place connected to the brain. But first, to be a disaster of literature. A voice came saying, this baby is a man. Take the fall and send it to the government. Take an exercise. Do not forget where you came from and your name to land. What's your name, my cheater? Alexander Lukashenko. My name is not Alexander Lukashenko. And I have sinned many things. Interestingly, you do not have to wait. He is 5 years old and his debt is debt. 2 years later, sick and medicine, his mother later. Bacon, spices, and Alex likes to leave his mother. His daughter-in-law went to her uncle's daughter. There is a heavy odor and they cannot enter. A voice says, Alex, you have to defend yourself. He began to use the spirit in educational activities. I do not work because it's easy to try. He died. No refund fees. Macintosh. Back to my mother. Diabetes is not available for sale. Scamodium. Each book can get your hands. Planet. See below for treatment. In the ancient world. The bracket. You can log in to New York.
You can log in.
Hey, can be so.
You can log in.
Hey, can be so.
You can log in to New York.
Search why
Alexander Lukashenko. Alexander Lukashenko.
Waiting for the event.
Wait for you. Cannot escape. Can never relax. Oh, Hamilton, Alaska.
Hamilton, Alaska.
Americans will invite you.
Do you know this great sense? How do you
get there?
Does not like the world yet.
Put your shirt to replace it. Try to expand. There are other countries. Sorry.
Wait for yourself.
His family's destroyed. His rope and dairy lining.
We have to cope with him.
Am I? I'm going to die. Now with the mamas.
Now he liked it.
Am I? I am very crazy.
I have a million of mistakes. Food search why?
What hooks your letter me?
Alexander Lukashenko.
What's up, everybody? My name is Melinda Kathleen Reed.
All right, Melinda. And we're back. Thanks for hanging out with her. If you want to add free experience, tune in live Thursdays at 10 p.m. Eastern at geek-io.net/live.
Wait, we're live?
Yes.
Shit. Twitch broke again.
Who broke Twitch?
There we go. We're back.
We're back.
Oh, man. So those who have not had the lovely experience of listening to her stuff, she, is exactly what you think it is by Google Translate things. She runs Line Stuff songs through Google Translate 6 or 7 times, and that's what you get. It's a thing of brilliance, and she's an amazing person.
But she can't log into New York.
But she can't log into New York, and diabetes is definitely not for sale.
Yeah, I heard that. I'm like, oh. Yeah, exactly. Well, like, we make profit off of diabetes here in Florida. What are you talking about?
I'm glad that that's one truth that sails the seas, let me tell you.
Well, I mean, given that this is a soda cup that exists, which, by the way, these souvenir movie cups make great great tools if you want to hydrate yourself.
Yeah, they do.
I didn't know where that sentence was ending. Just want to FYI. They make good tools, period.
Yeah, and what's the point? You got a problem with them?
You make a circle.
And then you live in Tampa Bay. All right, let's move on.
Yes. Oh, man. So, it's the second half of the show, which means it is time to get out. All right, time to grill our guest. Hi, Peter. How are you?
Relax. Relax. What's going on?
Chilling.
You know. I've just been listening.
Well, time for listening to stop.
All right. Time for listening to
stop. I love your super stylish shuffling.
Oh, no, I'm sorry. I was just shuffling. I'm practicing to see what I'm playing, and so far I hit the deck. Sorry, never mind.
No, but it looks really. No, I'm saying like it looks really cool.
Just pick it up.
I'm gonna have to go back and clip that. Clip that, Peter, just throwing his deck just off screen.
I'm surprised it stayed so close together.
Right.
Wow,
we
magic.
Shattered it a little bit, but it's fine. That's another deck.
It's Bobbity. He's making a run with Bobbity. All right.
So what you're saying is you're competent at handling more than one deck at once?
I'm testing like 9 decks right now.
All
I'm testing one of
Oh.
Yeah, Peter handles all the decks, if you know what I mean.
We love our guests. We love our bread.
Dale, what's with that suitcase? Dale.
Yeah, weird that suitcase just automatically popped out of the closet and packed itself. Funny how that works.
We like to have fun.
Of course.
We have fun.
So, Peter, I didn't tell anybody who you played for or anything like that, so tell us a little bit about yourself.
Oh, my name's Peter Catani. I'm 28. I try to hide that as much as possible. I live in Miami, Florida, and I play card games, and I hide that as much as possible, too. A lot of people don't know that about me. Right now I'm embarrassed because this whole clean shave thing, I hate this look, but I'm going to dress as guest star on Saturday for the big event, and I'm going to clean it up more, but he has a clean face, so we have to go with that, and it's super cold here, so like it's affecting the chin, for God's sake. Like I'm outside and my chin's cold, I'm like, this sucks.
Yeah, what the fuck is this feeling on my chin? I don't understand.
Yeah, it's new to me. What else about me? You ask questions and I answer. There you go. I don't know what the hell to say about me.
Is that how being a guest work? You answer questions that are asked? I didn't know that. Huh.
So you play as a sponsored player for Pro Play Games in Miami, correct?
Yes, I do.
All right. How did you wind up with them?
They saw what so there was another card shop back then, it was called The Rock. And when Pansy was around, I brought a lot of people into the shop there because I worked at The Rock. And cool, you know, I had a turnout of like 20 to 30 people come in. Awesome. Pansy was an awesome game. Love that game. And it's Dragon Ball Z. Automatically, I was down for it.
Right.
When Bandai screwed Panini from the rights and the game died, lost everyone. Cool. And whatever. My use at the shop wasn't as good because that was the only game I was good at promoting, because Yu-Gi-Oh promotes itself, Magic promotes itself, all those other games, but like new games, something I'm into, awesome. So then PPG opened up close by, and they saw Super was coming out, and they called me, and they're like, we want you to rep Super for us. Cool. Problem is, not that I did a vow, because I don't want to say I vowed never to play this game, but I didn't want to play a game where I was like, it's going to die. Screw it. But they convinced me. I studied it up. The game did look fun. It had the equivalent of Pokemon, Naruto, Vanguard all together in one game. And these are all games I love playing. So, all right, screw it, let's play. And we got our community together. And with PPG and me, we got a bunch of people. And our turnouts are like also like 20 to 40 people. Depends if a new set comes out. A new set comes out, everyone comes back. Once they hate the format, we lose half. But that's every card game. Yep. So since then, I've been playing for PPG, and I recently just started traveling to places because I'm a very casual player. I hate playing meta. But for these big events, I like to challenge myself and play more serious. So yeah, and PPG pays me when I do good, so we really do try. Give my mom a reason to be like, hey, look, this is not a waste of time. But
convincing your parents your hobbies are not a waste of time.
Yeah,
that is the uphill battles.
I don't know what that feels like.
Hi, mom. Are you watching? Hi, mom.
No, for audio like players, I looked over my shoulder at the giant Geek IO flag I have behind my shoulder.
No, my mom knows I've always been a nerd and shit. And then, like, any girl I talk to usually know I'm a nerd because they're like, why are you out all day? Oh, look, I'm just playing cards, okay? It's nothing bad.
that is not just, with another know, like, woman. I've
never heard.
Play cards.
Yeah. And it's just funny. Especially, like, since what they think of me when they first meet me. Like, when they first meet me, they think I'm hot. And then when they get to know me, they think I'm cute. There's a big difference between hot and cute.
There is a huge difference. Okay.
So, you learn that. But, I'm me. I do me. I would skip football practice just to play cards. When I would go into the classroom in high school where everyone was playing like Yu-Gi-Oh at the time, they thought I was there to like steal and stuff. I'm like, no, I have cards. I know how to play.
Bitch, it's time to duel.
Yeah.
It's time to duel. Let's do this thing.
So I just enjoy playing and stuff. That's why I'm here. And the fact that I'm able to travel is pretty cool. The team that I'm with, it's awesome. We're kind of like a little family. We all joke around. Yeah, it's good time.
That's awesome. When did you get your start playing Yu-Gi-Oh! And card games, or what did you start playing?
The first real card game was Pokemon. I collected them. Didn't know how to play at all, but I collected them. And that was in elementary where, you know, people would just kind of like, my first card was a Blastoise. Like my first holo. I was like, oh, awesome. And I'm in kindergarten. Guy traded me an Arcanine and a Jinx. They're both common cards from like a starter deck for my Poliwrath, and I got raped. And that's like my first experience of learning about card games. Cool. Then middle school happened. Yu-Gi-Oh! Came out. We started playing that. Kind of got the hang of it. Didn't know the whole tribute mechanic. Learned a little more. Awesome. Then my friends did a sin and taught me magic and went super heavy on that. And then I found out my biological father played magic, and he had collection from like beta and stuff. He had, damn. I had like every, no, I had dual lands and dual lands. Oh man, I was the coolest guy when I came back from visiting my father. Problem is, I'm an idiot though. Cause like, I didn't give a damn about playing legacy, modern or anything. So I traded all those dual lands for like all the standard cards.
Oh.
And cool. Yeah. That's everybody's reaction when they know that about me.
Well, that's like when I tell people my dad had an Uncanny X-Men #1 and his mom threw it out.
Yeah, stuff like that, exactly like this. And, like, I see what the price they're going for of, like, Underground Seas and stuff, or, like, for, like, lands and stuff. I'm like, damn, I messed up. I super messed up. Because, like, for standard, ooh, I had the fancy stuff. But after rotation, they were crap. Also, yep. I traded those standard cards for a Vanguard collection, because I want to get into Vanguard. Awesome. I have done some bad mistake trades in my life, so I try not to trade as much anymore. So anytime someone comes up to me in events, and it's like, hey, do you have trades? No, I don't. I have nothing.
I cannot trust myself.
It's not you, it's me.
I don't have a damn thing. But, yeah, so I've tried every game out, gave it a shot, and most of the time I like it. And most of my money I waste here or on girlfriends. So, yeah, that's kind of what goes on with me.
God, I love those expensive hobbies and card games.
Very expensive hobbies. Card games and cards are
very expensive. Very true. Go ahead, next question. I think I'm giving really detailed answers.
Yes.
No, it's good.
You love it. No, yeah, don't hold back.
So what is your, aside from getting paid to play card games, because I know it's going to be your answer, what's the best thing about being a sponsored or a quote professional card player or game player for that matter?
I don't know if I'm professional yet. No, just some people like know who I am because of PPG. They force me to do videos. that's the best answer I can give you because I don't like being in front of a camera. I'm kind of shy. I'm getting more of like a flavor for it, and cool, it's fun. And
yeah, this guy's like, I'm ugly to me on Facebook Messenger. I'm like, what the hell are you talking about?
Fuck you.
Well, no, I could be better. This crap sucks. I hate it. I like my beard. And it sucks because I met a girl. And cool, she's all into me and stuff. And she's like, wait, but why'd you shave? I'm like,
oh.
It was just something.
No, you had a girl.
The beard aficionados.
Oh no, the beard. Oh,
he's the chin, and it's all over.
But the main thing that makes this fun and worth it is literally the people. Because me, I'm just there to play cards. But like, when everyone's coming up to me and it's like, hey, you're that guy. Can you sign my card and stuff? Man, I love all that crap. I'm just like, this is awesome. Hey, what's up? And I try to be all friendly and stuff. What's funny, though, if you actually see how I talk to like my close friends, it's completely different how I talk to the rest of the world.
Right.
But like, I think that's fair. I think that's everybody. You know? Like, my mom calls me and she's like, how much you want now? I'm like, no, mom, I'm calling to say I love you. But like, she answers the phone to everyone else. Hi, this is Cynthia. How may I help you? Of course, yeah, mom, of course. Everyone's okay in the world.
We get that one because like going to conventions and shit like that, where you like I always say that I have a radio persona and it is mostly just me amped to 11. But like anybody who meets me in real life, like. Like, how are you quiet? Like,
yeah,
because I am.
I'm quiet too. Exactly.
There's a story of when I went to America in for the Disney half marathon. This was 2 years ago. 2 years ago? 3 years ago?
Mm-hmm.
2 years ago now. And then literally CJ and I slept on the way to Disney. It was like
the
weirdest thing ever because we're like very open and bubbly thing.
Marathon, that was when you first came in. You were going down I-4 the second time when we were on our way to the marathon. Nobody was sleeping in that car.
No one was sleeping in that car.
I feel you on that one. It's such a weird thing, like when you have to open up a fan page because you have fans. Like I don't understand.
Yeah, it's crazy.
Yeah,
because like I feel bad.
Fans?
Oh, go ahead.
What's it like having fans?
It's super cool. It's just I feel bad because like they'll ask for like friend requests, and normally I don't mind, but the amount that came out, I'm just like, oh, whoa, this is for like family and just like certain friends. I don't like invite anyone, so I made a fan page because I'm not trying to reject anybody. It's just like no, add me in this thing. But problem is the system on the phone with the fan page is horrible because it goes to like desktop,
yep.
And like my messenger is not as smooth. It's laggy and stuff, and I'm just like, oh, it's horrible. So now I'm not gonna cancel it, but like since I don't have a laptop for myself, I'm trying to figure out like do I cancel it and just put everyone on my page or how does it work? But the amount of messages, like I still need to respond to people. I was actually gonna do that today, but since I was paying attention to this, I'm like, no, I gotta make sure I'm here. And then take care of that and play test. Like, thank God I'm at least play testing now. I'm just seeing the hands, and you can tell a lot of a deck by just looking at hands. Like, I made this card.
Come on, Peter. I'm gonna charge a coercion, and I'm gonna drop a Majin Buu. I'm gonna draw one card.
No, wait, hold on, Bloodlust.
Fuck!
Ah,
that didn't work out as well as you'd hope.
Injured.
You got too comfortable.
Yeah, right. Too comfortable.
Ah. Now my boo is sad and covered by frickin' Frieza.
But yeah. Good time.
So, like, tell us a little bit about your strategy going into big events like this. Not at all trying because I want to go into a big event like this in a couple of weeks.
How do you prepare? How do you prepare for a big event?
It's literally playtesting till 5 in the morning before. We have 3 hours of sleep. I think in Vegas I had 15 minutes of sleep. It's bad because like
it's Vegas too, so you can deal with all the people around you. Fucking, let's go do this. No,
We went to Vegas and we didn't enjoy any of Vegas. We just played. We played, and once we were done. Like we were tired. We're like, yo, we just want to sleep.
I can't look at another fucking card. Screw the blackjack table.
No, especially after these events. Like for a week, I don't look at Dragon Ball Z. I don't give a damn about Dragon Ball Z. New cards get spoiled. I'm like, I don't care. Yeah. The following week, I'm like, okay, we gotta get prepared for the next event. But these take a lot out of us. Like I'm just talking about the team in general. Even all of us are just like, nope. You want to meet up for wings? Hell yeah. You want to play cards? Nope. And it's funny too because everyone always messages and they're like, hey, what are you gonna play and stuff? And some of them are just casual players. They don't care to like try to get advantage or like knowledge of what I'm playing. They just are trying to make combo, and it's totally fine. But I'm 100% honest when I'm like, I don't know.
Yeah.
And I'll give them a list of what I'm playing. Like I'll be like, I'm playing this, and this, like what I'm interested in testing. But once I get here, like today we tested, and I've tested two decks, and I realize I hate them. I'm like, all right, gotta switch it to something. But we're completely lost. These colorless cards. Black cards. I call them black, but like I'm trying not to be racist.
Well, no, they are black cards. I mean, because they're coming out with the fifth. I mean, it's a fifth color, so they produce black mana. But it's the fifth color, so they're going all they're going full magic on us.
Okay, perfect. So the black cards.
You are not being racist. It's actually a thing.
No. And you weren't racist first. Just want to put that out. You weren't racist.
Yeah, Bandai's racist. I mean, just look at Popo.
Yes. No, just because like two of our teammates are Marcel and Eddie. They are dark skinned, and if you see how I talk to them, they're very fun. So again, try to hide as much as I can to the outside world of my personality. So like in Richmond, Marcel was undefeated. So I was joking, and I'm like our white knight. And at one point, I thought he lost because he was rolling up his mat. And so I'm like, no way, our white knight lost. And the judge was like, who? I'm like, our white knight. Who's that? My bad. Okay, the black knight. And I instantly laughed. And like, again, not racist, but he understood. So in all fairness.
Well, I mean, the black knight always triumphs.
Yes.
Exactly. And that was the case. He was rolling up his mat because he was just transferring to another table to play the next person. He was on a roll that day.
So, explain to me the whole team thing, because that's not something I'm familiar with hearing with a lot of trading card games.
This is technically the first time I can say I'm on a team. Like, before, like, playing Yu-Gi-Oh!, I had a group. It was, like, four of us. We traveled to, like, the furthest, I think, was Atlanta, Georgia. But that was, like, a team. No, this time it's literally a logo, shirt, hat, and we're representing an actual store. From like when we go out, it's normally 7 to 8 of us, and there's a few other players, but they can't like travel. So technically, the team is only 7 to 8 of us, if you count the owner, because he comes and travels and plays with us. Surprisingly, he does good too. I've known that guy forever. No, I've known his name is George Machado. I've known him forever, and he's a decent player for sure. But whenever we play, I didn't take him as anything of a threat. So anytime you talk, I'm like, dude, how? And everyone in the team is asking how, because he takes forever. But it's cool. He's doing good. And
he's the store owner. Of course he knows the heart of the cards.
Yeah. No. He's doing really good. And the playtesting. Yeah. It's the playtesting that we do, because we, like, right now, if I wasn't talking to you guys, we would be all with 5 decks right now, just be like, all right, this one, because I have my group on here on the side. One's sleeping, the other one's like, so it's Christabella sleeping. The other guy is the dude that won Connecticut, the first regional.
Yeah.
So, we play test, and the other half of our team is in the other room, but one of the guys farted, so I made sure not to be in that room. Yeah,
by the way, I want to point out that Team PPG has won all three of the Dragon Ball Super Regionals. So, you know, there's some kind of...
Out of four. Out of four.
Nah,
out of four, we won three. Okay. And it's a shame, too, because, like, the one that we didn't win, they were rooting for me because I was in top four. And in that match, it was, like, my first event, like, my first big one. So I got, like, a little bit nervous and I didn't play test the Android matches. So I'm like, no, I'm going to lose. I did lose top four and I got third, but afterwards, once I got home to Miami and we play test, I learned the Android matchup. That matchup was so free. I'm like, I'm an idiot. I'm such an idiot. I at least could have got second or first my first event, but whatever. Now I make sure to test every deck that I kind of think was going to be there. But yeah.
Man, Bobbity's going to come in and wreck your face.
Oh, I hope. Like,
right, that's exactly what happened. Like, Bob, I'm with you. Like, we had a pre-show discussion of, like, talking about weird leaders, and Bobbity's one of them, and he's fantastic. Like, he just does so much. And just, like, I want him to do something.
The only reason, like, I can't justify playing it, and I can't convince anyone to let me just play, because I don't really have a choice. yeah, just to give a heads up. He's 10K on the flip side. If he was just 11K, which still can't hit anything, if he was 11K and not to be hit by Android 20, by a Weave, by anything, then he had so much potential to be actually a leader. But the fact that he's a 10K both sides, you can't play him competitively. He had to be one more.
Yeah.
And that's the truth. And that's the only problem. The same thing with Chill. Chill has such an interesting mechanic with spawns of tokens. The problem is the only good card is the 5-drop, and that's so late when he's a 10K just getting swarmed. Like, you can Sensu Bean, and it's irrelevant because you're 15. You're the equivalent of a regular leader, and you're still getting hit.
Yeah.
So those leaders, I can't do anything. I try to be a little bit creative. Like, I know people want to see, like, a red leader win. And all the red leaders, other than, like, Vegito, and Vegito doesn't offer much. No one gets anything. If you want to play Champa, which has the mechanic of drawing, you should just play Trunks. He's a much better one without having to swing with a 15K. You can swing with Mighty Mouse turn two, just pump it once, and draw for that card you pump and search two. It's just better. And these big events, like, sure, you can play fan favorites or cards that, oh, this is my favorite card, I love this card, and cool, have fun. But if you want to try to win, you got to play a little more serious. Right now, go ahead, please.
No, you go.
Since all four regionals have been different leaders that have won, I'm trying to do my best to keep it like that. So I'm trying this guy. Yeah, because he's actually my favorite leader. It's Golden Frieza. Cool. I couldn't win with Mecha, so I'm taking off the armor and going gold. But that's the little joke I have. But I'm having a difficult time because the black cards make it difficult to... I'm a control player, and those black cards you just can't prepare for.
I fell a blue player in Magic.
Yeah, no. In Magic, I'm Simic. I love green blue. Those are, like, my favorite combination. In Yu-Gi-Oh, Counter Fairies, that's my favorite thing. I've always been
Dale's
a control player. Yeah.
Yeah, Dale's my favorite Counter Fairy. He's the best Counter Fairy.
Don't. Stop it. Hang on, I can fix this. Hang on. Yep, there we go. This bit's always great for the audio listeners, where I put on my sparkly hat. It's always great.
I like it.
But, you need a sparkly sound effect for the soundboard, so they all know.
Now that the lights are faint, I can't really see it because, you know, it's in the middle of the day.
But, that's what's going on with me right now. So,
nice.
I think that was a good answer. Go ahead.
There you go. I wanted to ask, how do you go about kind of building a deck and playing with decks around sort of tournament rules as opposed to, like, casual with your friends sort of rules? Is there anything special that you have to consider, or?
No, when it comes to, like, let's say locals, a lot of people didn't know that I was good at this game because, like, in locals, the first two rounds I'll lose. Like, I'm playing such a crap deck that, like, they're like, oh, he's nobody. And all of a sudden they find out that, like, I won Richmond or I topped Orlando and stuff like that. Him? What the hell? In locals, I don't play Series X. I'll play whatever the hell that I see interesting. Like, yeah, this leader looks cool. Cool, let me test it. I do bad, it doesn't matter to me. I don't care. At least I learn how to play that leader. I learned what
you lost, like, $5 if you're actually paid for it. You lost $5 in a local tournament. Not a big deal.
Yeah, and you get a promo pack for entering. So, like, no matter what it's worth.
It's a participation tournament. Everybody gets one.
Yeah. It would be better if I could, get credit. But whatever. As long as I learn something about the leader, so when I play against it, I kind of have a mindset where I'm like, okay, I know what it does. In Orlando, no, it was in Vegas, someone was playing Galactic Frieza. That's the leader that at the end of the turn, you untap one of your creatures, and it was like round 7. Like, how the hell are you still here? But in a very nice way, of course. But in my head, I was thinking... but in my head, I was like, no way. And I already tried out how that leader plays. It plays with Android... 19 when it attacks, draw a card.
Yep.
So, like, turn 2, he'll bring it out, swing 10, cool, but then untap. So every turn, he has a draw mechanic. I'm like, that's fancy. It wasn't enough for the deck I was playing at the time, but it's really cool seeing leaders like that when someone brings something to the table. He actually topped 32. He got there and lost in 32, but the fact that he got there is enough. Yeah. So that was something. So when it comes to locals and big events, locals, man, I'm just trying out everybody. I don't care if that's good or not. I'm not trying to win. I'm just trying to learn. And then big events, I'm playing. I'm mindset to be like, all right, I'm here to try to win for the shop. Shop pays me. Awesome. Everyone wins.
Everyone's a winner, yeah. plus also you would probably take those skills and the techniques that you've learned in local games and, of course, you know, if they're successful, you take them to the tournament. So
that's kind of what's going on with me. It's just a lot of playtesting, and that sets me up. We didn't know about Starter Deck Goku. My whole store, my locals, we had an idea, but like with all training, we thought it was whatever. In Vegas, I got top 8, and I lost to Starter Deck Goku, but he was a monster. Like. I never care losing. I don't care about losing. If I lose, I lose. It's not a big deal. But when I get destroyed, it bothers me a little bit.
Yeah.
Not because of the opponent or anything. It's just like in my head, I'm like, what happened? Yeah, like it's like, why was I so like defenseless? Like in life, I'm not defenseless. So like I'm just not experienced in this. I'm like, what the hell happened? And that's when I learned about that deck and I studied it. I'm like, this deck is fantastic. And that's the reason I did good in Richmond. But then everyone already knew that deck was fantastic. So this mirror match sucked. But I love this card. And because of this card, I don't play Mecha anymore. Like, I'd even tried right now to test Mecha. I'm like, oh, Mecha with black card's cool. And then the same mechanic happened where it's like, damn, I didn't draw Objection with Monaco. This deck sucked. Never mind.
Yep.
This card. This is the truth. I love this card. And it's a shame that there's only 2 leaders that untap because being tapped out in this game is so bad, and only certain leaders help you with that. So Starter Deck Goku, those three, and Frieza are the main ones. Because Vegeta, as much shit talking as I do to that leader, I hate that leader. I know to respect it, and I know never to be tapped out with it. So right now how the game is, there's only certain leaders you can play unless someone has broke it and beat all of us. Because whatever I'm gonna play, I'm pretty sure half the team is going to play, because that's how we are. We play test, we try to find the best deck. Once we realize it, we all kind of go into that same deck in our own variants and play it. And then you have Marcel and Eddie with the Vegeta. But I try to get everyone out of that. But cool. I don't want Vegeta to win. That's damn sure. I just hate when Vegeta wins.
I would love to see Vegito, who got a pretty, decent little boost off of the black cards in the new set. Vegito, I love Vegito in theory, mainly because I just like red leaders.
Definitely, and he's 3 colors. That's huge.
Yeah.
He
just automatically makes your deck a gold deck, like if for Magic players. It's insane, and like I love like the character's great. Do you watch any of the Dragon Ball stuff? Like, at all?
Yeah, what's up?
No, just morbidly curious, like me saying, referencing any of the characters, and you're like, because I've met a couple people, like, I've never even seen an episode of anything Dragon Ball, I'm just here because these cards look cool.
No, I know more or less, maybe not names perfectly, but, like, I know Jiren. I know Tapo. Hippo, the Tapo. Big arm dude. The Rabba. The Rabbit. I know. I learned certain things. I've watched all through Z. Z I know by heart. And Super, I've caught glimpses. I've seen the Trunks saga and the Tournament of Power saga. Those are the main two. And I think those are the only two. Yeah.
And those
and
are those
almost
are
nothing in GT. Really, I know more or less some stuff, but yeah.
Is there anyone from the show that is not in the game yet that you would like to see as, like, a leader? Or are they all pretty?
So, in the very first episode, when Raditz appears... No. When Raditz appears, the very first episode, I say it. Every little, like, banner that they make us write for Top 32, like, oh, what character would you like to see in the next set? In the first episode, there was a guy with a shotgun.
Farmer with shotgun.
Make him a cart. I don't care if he's a leader, if he's just a little regular blocker, but just make him. He was hilarious in the show. He literally had a shotgun. His power level was 5 because of the shotgun. It dropped it. It became 0. It was perfect. I want him to be a character, so that's my character that I want.
Oh, my gosh.
That, like, yeah.
I totally support that. It's fantastic.
It's the first 2 minutes. You'll see it.
Yeah.
Make a Karibo deck of shotgun farmer guy.
Shotgun farmer guy.
So yeah, that's who I'm hoping for. Also, I wouldn't mind seeing like Nappa and Raditz because I'm pretty sure they're not here, and their power levels be so weak. But what they can, I don't know.
Power levels are bullshit, anyways.
Pansy made Raditz demon. Like Raditz was Raditz dominated Pansy. Like and
well, understand Pansy. No, Pansy did everything that was crap characters into god characters. Krillin dominated that format. Wait. Fucking Yamcha was amazing. Like, Piccolo was incredible. Like, anyone who was bad in the show fucking was incredible in the game. So that's how Pansy worked. In this one, like, if they make weak lasers again, like, let's say Bobby as an example, it's the same concept I said. Like, the flip side, just make it 11. They don't have to be 15 because they're technically weak, but make them 11 so they're playable. And boom, solves the problem. They're still weak leaders, but not everything can attack it. That's what I'm hoping.
So, like, on the flip side of dealing with fans and all those weird things, like, because PPG gets some shit in the community. Like, what, how do you feel about that and how do you deal with that?
Oh, it's fun. If we have haters, it's because we're doing something right. And, like, it's the truth, because I almost, it's not like I'm captain or anything, but there's no one in this team that talks crap. No one acts better than anybody here in this team. That's something that's kind of important, because we're all laid-back people. So if one person's like that, we automatically would be like, oh, shoot.
Maybe we should have somebody else on this team, because you're a great player, but you're a shit person. Get out of here.
Yeah, it's one of those, like, because PPG likes to have an image. They want to be known, and to be known for being, like, cocky players, that's horrible. No, we don't want that. We're known to be good, helpful, and good in these events, because we do playtest a lot. And there's only two players, Eddie and Marcel, are the only two players that are not Miami. I believe Marcel is close to Jackson, and Eddie is like an hour away. But they'll drive to come to our locals to play test with us, because they're just committed, and they love this game. They also play Octagon, like, nonstop. Either way, they're dedicated, and they also have great personalities. Eddie tremendously tries to help the community with everything. Tries to get people in, and super friendly. And events, if you go to him and you show that you subscribe to this channel and PPG, he gives you a pack for free. Like, thank you, man. Super cool dude. And Marcel, quiet guy. But lately, he's building some confidence, because technically his record is better than mine. Since he's so quiet, I forget. I know we play test, but I forgot that he was so good. In Orlando, he got top 8. In Vegas, he got first. In Richmond, he got second. I have 3rd, 8th, and 1st. So he's beating me by a 2nd and a 3rd. So this tournament, to me, I'm kind of in a race with him. He just doesn't know it yet. so, yeah. And the thing is, he's taking his deck. Like, somebody had the nerve to say one-trick pony. Like, I don't know how you say stuff about that. Like, something like that to someone who loves playing that deck. Like, it's not that he's playing it because it's good, because technically it's not good. But that's his
right,
favorite
deck.
Yeah. No, no, he's decent. Like, the leader's decent, but, like, I just hate him.
All right, cut and show. We're out of here.
Understand. No, you know what it's at? No, okay, let me rephrase that, because in the show, Vegeta's the shit. That guy's awesome. But I hate him because of this game, because set one, he made the game extremely boring for me. I hate that every game is Vegeta, Vegeta, Vegeta. And mind you, before I was doing this whole travel, playing big events, my locals, I'm playing different decks. I'm just like, I'm stuck at five. He's creating. And like, I knew result was a card, but like, I was trying to stay away from blue too, because who the hell didn't play blue in set one?
Right.
So yeah, it made everything difficult, and that's where the hate of Vegeta came from, not from the show. I actually think Vegeta's really cool. But yeah.
I thought you were talking crap about Vegeta on the show. I'm like, oh, Mary, it's time to time to play the lullaby.
I had to be clear, because clearly I was messing up there. But yeah,
you don't talk shit about the second best dad in the show. First, of course, being Piccolo.
Yeah, of course. Yeah, no, I was going to say that too. I was like, Piccolo, and Goku's a horrible father, so you're right. Yeah, second best dad.
Let's be honest, Goku is the worst character in his own show.
He really is.
You think so? Well, I think the worst father, sure. Worst character, no, the guy's a badass.
He's a good fighter as a character.
No, good fighter and good-hearted, too. And that's what it is. Everything else, he's kind of selfish. When he threw a sense of being a cell, like, holy shit, you're an idiot.
Do you watch Dragon Ball Z Abridged at all?
I've caught a few episodes. Some have really.
Which concussion? Maybe less.
Yeah, they finally caught the Senzu being up to cell thing on there, and yeah, it's like Piccolo grabs him. Which concussion was it, Goku? Which concussion made you think that this was a good idea?
It's glorious. You need to watch the episode.
Do me a favor, tag me, or like, you know, send me a message with that link, because I suck at finding stuff. But if you send it to me, I'll definitely watch it.
Yeah,
that sounds awesome. The last one I saw was, Goku and Gohan were coming out of the hyperbolic time chamber, and all I remember was Popo was there, and Vegeta was like, don't you think that's funny, black man? He's like, yeah, almost funny if you call me that again. And stuff like that. I was like, yes. That's what it was.
Popo
hilarious.
Popo is one of the best characters in Abridged.
In Abridged,
exactly,
yeah.
That reason.
Yes.
So, he's such a throwaway character in the actual series, and the Abridged team made him this absolute eldritch horror monstrosity.
Yes. But, Yes, do me a favor, remember, just send me that link. I definitely want to watch it.
Yeah, I got you.
But, let's see. I think I answered the question decently. Sorry.
You've been great, dude. you're stressing out. You're doing great, man. But we'll go ahead and unless anybody else has any other questions for you. I know, like, I've kind of been dominating this, as I kind of assumed I would, being, you know, the only Dragon Ball Super player on the show.
I got the one question I write down in. That's
so we're actually, unless anybody else has anything, go ahead and begin our wrap up here.
The hot minute that I had written down here, I got in there.
Yeah, that was
my hot minute.
The hottest of minutes.
Oh.
All right, so Peter, why don't you tell the folks at home where people can see a little bit more about you or PPG or anything like that?
Oh no, well, PPG is doing their own thing, like, in the sense, like, you go to PPG, you find apparently the best prices. Not apparently, I have to say it. The best prices online, the lowest. No, they do really good at, like, trying to.
No, they do have some pretty rad prices. Like, I look at them, I'm like, man, like, my locals, I love my locals. I really do. But, just, yeah.
they're doing good. Like, sooner or later, we're going to catch up. Or I think PPG is going to catch up to the equivalent of, like, what Cool Stuff is, or ARG. Just give them time. They're so brand new. But in the span of maybe 3-2 years, they've done so much that they're only going to get better. And yeah, no. When it comes to looking for me, you can find me on Facebook and or my face or my fan page thing. Either one. I want everyone to go to the fan page. But if you write to me on my group, technically it's easier. So most likely I'll respond faster. But yeah, no, finding me is easy. And I do respond eventually. It doesn't take a week. I promise you that much. It takes a day or two. It
took me a week. I don't know what you're talking about.
No, I'm sorry if it did. But I responded, and I'm here. I kept my word. I am here. So that much was here, and I think it's been a good show.
No, absolutely. So, next question. Sure. All right, so we're going to go ahead, and then we're going to go ahead and get this wrapped up, because Dale has to get out of here, and I'm going to go ahead and let you get back to doing, you know, your part-time job. Of play card games, you lucky bastard.
Not mad. Hashtag not mad.
Dude, I've been playing card games since 1994. The fact that he's playing card games and gets paid for it.
1994. Boy, you make me feel young.
Shadow Ranger came out then.
Yeah.
Is it past your bedtime?
All right, you can of course listen to us live Thursdays at 10 p.m. Eastern, 7 p.m. Pacific, Fridays at 1 p.m. Australian Eastern Standard Time at twitch.tv/geekioshow. If you want to get a hold of us, you can do so at geekioshow@gmail.com. Twitter, Facebook, all the social medias are /geekioshow. And of course, you can give us a call on our geek hotline. Leave us a voicemail, 727-489-4335. That is 727-489-geek. We also have a Discord that you guys can join us by going over to geek-io.net/discord, and you can support us on Patreon by going over to patreon.com/geekio for more access to us via, you know, master feed, hidden Discord channels, some cool stuff that we got planned coming up, and all that good jazz.
Awesome. That was really good.
Hey, John, it's almost like I've been doing this for 5 years.
Yeah.
Well, it's like Dale actually updated the template.
I make a joke of I can do this with my eyes closed, and Raul, our producer, the asshole that he is, deletes the entire show notes, and I still do the outro without him. He's just like, well, there we go.
At that point, you gotta be impressed.
Proud, almost.
Hey, Josh, what do we got going on next week, my man?
Next week, we are McFalling back on our asses on the couch and watching Bright.
Yeah. Will Smith goodness onto the Netflix.
Which apparently has already been greenlighted for a sequel, so there's that.
Yeah, I still haven't seen it yet. I've purposely been holding it off until we've done the rant and review of it. So this will be exciting. I've been wanting to see it.
I caught a little bit of it when Taco Lady was watching it on her own time, and it seemed all right.
Apparently it's not for the kids though, so if you're watching it with the show, might not want to watch it with the children, from what I've heard.
Ooh, things get a little
Yeah, apparently it's just unless of course ultra violence is a turn off for you, like, yeah.
All or right. Turn on.
Or turn on, yeah. I mean, all right, you guys.
Takes all types.
It's time for
Now it's time for the Geek Island Winter Movie SmackDown Update.
Nothing has changed. Moving on.
Dale, if that still makes you cringe, just re-record it as Water Buffalo.
You may or may not be just giving away a future bumper that I may or may not be making.
Oh, jeez.
I teased it.
We're 5 weeks in. We got a little bit. We have to start planning for the summer. But yeah, I mean, nothing has changed. Den of Thieves, which nobody saw, is ending its run. Maze Runner is in its second week, which like five people are seeing. And Winchester has lost all running that I've seen of it. So yeah, nothing.
I mean, there'll be only ghosts in the movie theater.
Yes. Jeff, Jared, Carrie, Raul, Josh, me. It might change in a couple of weeks when Black Panther comes out for Josh, but I still don't.
But you can't. He paid like $900 for it, so yeah, based off our rules, you don't know. Yeah. I mean, Star Wars didn't rocket carry in the first place, mainly because it flopped. But if it hadn't flopped, then...
No, it didn't flop. Its second week drop-off was too steep.
Yeah. That's true. Angry fanboys and all.
Yep.
Strike it through the cannon! It's not the same! It was too different!
Change.org have to have something on their front page.
Hey Dale, what do we got going on next week? Or what's been going on this week?
Next week what we've got going on is... We've been falling on that, never mind. This week on the Geek I.O. Network, our generic live show is back live for 2018. And it was kind of a hot mess-ish. As we talked about our vacation and other people's vacations, but we absolutely didn't get mixed up on whose vacation we were talking about.
Nope. No, you did not.
Dale, how many times can you force vacation into that sentence?
Thank you. I was hoping someone else was going to pick up that.
I taught Dale how to open up live phone lines.
That's important.
And I crashed both of his pre-show and his post-show. And I got to say a word that I don't normally say, talking about a certain person in his vacation. And it's not Dale.
And it's not Dale. Spoiler alert, it was not my vacation.
No, and I showed up for the last 5 minutes of the stream.
Like you did.
Exactly. And Kerry enjoyed Wii Shop music, but it's on fire for the last 5 minutes. And found out what Oscar-nominated film describes your love... No, what... Yeah, what Oscar-nominated film describes your love life?
Yep.
And if you watch that, apparently, yeah, we won't. Yeah. Anyway, also, Generic Live hoodies are available right now over at geek-io.net/genericlivehome. Only available for $30, and they come in a selection of fabulous colors.
One of the ones that I won't buy because I live in Florida.
I mean, you had snowpocalypse for a week and a half.
Not here! It just got cold.
Yeah, some of our plants died. I'm hoping the plumerias survived.
The vine that was working its way down from our tree in the backyard is apparently dead.
Yeah.
I love Team Skull Admin Plumeria. She was great.
Yeah. And I really hope that the tree that she was named after in our front yard is alive, because I love those and it would be sad if they died.
Yeah, the front yard's awesome. Speaking of awesome trees, in this week's Manapool episode, the party gets themselves into the library! Ta-da! And they find Fighting Pitcher. The rest of the party makes a small donation, allowing them more access to the archives.
And yes, that segue makes sense.
Yes, it does.
Absolutely, 100% makes total sense. And also, tune in for next week, because... things are gonna get interesting. There's gonna be entertainment for all ages.
Yeah, there is. Woo. So, we've been adding some show title candidates to the show by going over to geekioshow.showbot.tv. And at this point, Carrie is going, Jesus.
There's a lot of these.
I have been having fun.
Half of them are Nightbot jokes.
We also have our first suggestion from a audience member, thanks to Quarrelsome Rhino, because everyone, not just show hosts, can add suggestions to Showbot.
Exactly.
What do you say?
Go ahead.
We're going to get to Peter.
We have, what are you throwing at me? Why is there a cow on a motorcycle? Most regional. You can do that here. What? Great show. Did we break Showbot already? Error connecting to remote server. It's only 9 hours. Everything's better with robots. You go next because you answered the question. The floor stripper is the best stripper. Magikarp spread. People Magikarp spread in touch tunnels. Our first grandma. Better than shitty days. Better disembodied than disemboweled? ? Nightbot is drunk tonight. Kangaroos life matter. Use them to make a circle and then you live in Tampa Bay. We like to have fun. You ask questions and I answer them. Card games and girlfriends. The fifth color. Everyone is a winner. Barbara with shotgun. Dale, shut up. Josh.
Dale something 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 Dale.
Oh, I didn't see the Dale's name in the showbot when I added something 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 Dale in there, because you have to have Dale's name in the show title community somewhere.
Well, it has to be a math equation though, so you know.
So
do in the show.
Dale, shut up, minus Josh.
Negative Dale plus shut up equals
Dale, shut Josh. Up minus Josh is what we're saying.
That's be negative Dale.
All right, folks. Like Peter, thank you so much for hanging out with us. Really appreciate you. And now I'm going to play some music to go and wrap us up. We'll talk to you guys next week. Bye.
Later, guys.
Bye.
Hi, my name is Border Buffalo, and I hope you've enjoyed this Geek I Media Network production. Copyright 2018, you see how that works?
Yep.
Diamond Club hopes you have enjoyed this program.